State Head Minister of State for Planning Amos Lugolobi has read the 44.7 trillion budget to the nation. Today in Kololo, we have the details.
The 44.778 trillion shillings budget 2021-2022 financial year has been read by the Ntanjero North Member of Parliament and the also appointed Minister of State for Planning Amos Lugolobi. The budget, crafted under the theme promoting industrialization for inclusive growth, employment and wealth creation, has allocations as below. 1.67 trillion shillings allocated to support agro-industrialization initiatives. 7.7 trillion shillings have been allocated for human capital development. 5.1 trillion to roads infrastructure development. 6.9 trillion for security. 1.1 trillion for energy infrastructure development. 560 billion shillings has been allocated for purchase of COVID-19 vaccines and 376.9 billion shillings to improve access for justice.
Energy facilities of 42,000 metric tons capacity in Iganga, Isingiro, Amuru, Kalungu, and Nebbi. Number nine, operationalized 20 zonal industrial hubs for skilling youth and women, wealth creation and value addition for carpentry, welding, tailoring, knitting, weaving, bakery, shoemaking and stone cutting trades, and value addition facilities for commodities such as coffee and maize. Number 10, construct two storage facilities in Bujangavu and Katakwi, six milk collecting centers in Chenjojo, Gomba, Nakaseke, Kumi and Kibuku, 12 food processing plants and 18 value addition facilities across the country. Number 11, operationalize the 1,000 metric ton grain processing plant and a 150 kilogram per hour peanut butter plant in Soroti, a 3,000 metric ton maize processing plant in Busia, and a 500 metric ton multi-grain processing plant and feed mill in Arua. 12, establish the Kavarore Agro-Industrial Park, two regional value addition incubation centers in Kasese and Guru, and two regional farm service centers in Guru and Kavarore.
Lugolobi assured the country that Uganda's public debt is still sustainable, standing at US$17.96 billion, which is an equivalent of 49.8% of the GDP. To keep the debt within sustainable levels, the government has come up with four strategies, including proper appraisal of government and restricting borrowing to only borrowing for projects that enhance socio-economic transformation.
The priority interventions in the mining industry next financial year are as follows. Number one, establish the mineral reserves that are economically feasible for extraction in 80% of the country, and complete the airborne geophysical surveys of the remaining 20% in the Karamoja sub-region. Number two, finalize the mining law and enhance public-private partnership arrangement to develop minerals, starting with the iron ore in Western Uganda, restoration of the Katwe salt factory, and provision of an attractive taxation regime that protects and supports local steel production. Three, explore all geothermal resources to quantify the geothermal potential of the country and promote the development of Kibiro, Katwe, Bulan.
Government has highlighted seven strategies to reduce public expenditure by 3.4%. Public spending is expected to reduce from 24.4% to 21.1% in the next financial year. This will be achieved through rationalizing government institutions, improving asset management, strengthening procurement, and eliminating accumulation of domestic arrears, digitization of public finance management systems, and further scale down of spending on conservative items. Story by Fred Kajumi for the news.